Shares have almost surged about 50% this year. Well, ever since global textile quotas have been erased, complaints against China's textile producers have been going up. And the latest battle involves the European Union and the leather shoemakers from China and Vietnam. EU Trade Commissioner Peter Mandelson proposed a 5-year duties on shoes from both countries, claiming that they were selling them below cost in Europe and taking business away from European shoemakers. Now, this sets up a showdown within the EU over how to fight the surge in Asian imports. So let's get an Asian perspective on this ongoing textile dispute. And I am joined by Sonny Lee, who is company secretary and also financial controller at Huafeng Textile International. That's a fabric maker which is listed here in Hong Kong. Well, good morning to you, Sonny. Thank you so
much
for coming into our lovely studios today. Now, global textile quotas, they have been abolished since January 1st, 2005.
Yes.
But we keep having these ongoing disputes with the European Union and the U.S. Do you actually think, from a textile industrialist's perspective, these quotas are fair, these tariffs?
Of course, especially the U.S., they have been trying to impose new measures against importers from China because of not so much on anti-dumping, but of course, all along the production cost in China is much lower than that in the Europe or in the U.S. So the EU and the U.S. government have been trying to prevent low-cost production going into their markets.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, next year we're going to see the abolishment of the quota system. And now they are thinking of different ways to control the import, and I think it's a bit unfair after so many discussions between the Chinese Ministry of Finance and various authorities. They have such a long negotiation and discussions with various authorities in the U.S. and in the European countries.
Now, as Huafeng, your company, it isn't directly impacted by these quotas because you usually make you make textiles and you also do dyeing and cotton production.
Yeah, Huafeng mainly dealing with dyeing, and we don't manufacture fabrics at this moment.
But do you expect maybe an indirect impact from these anti-dumping duties that would probably make Chinese textiles more expensive in the European Union, and they might cut back on their purchases of your products?
Yes, of course. If our customers face difficulties in sending their goods to the U.S. or the Europe, then obviously they will have less orders for us. That could pose an impact on our sales.
Well, let's talk about competition, rising competition from other low-cost developing countries. And all week we've been talking about Vietnam's developing economy there and their burgeoning production, maybe in textiles as well. Mm. But Bangladesh is also another big competitor for low-cost production of textiles. Are you afraid, or how are you sensing competition from these low-cost areas?
Of course, the labor costs in these countries, such as Bangladesh and Vietnam, would be much lower than that in China nowadays, such as maybe perhaps 10, 15, 20 years ago when Hong Kong manufacturers start moving into China. Of course, we do see some sort of competition from these low-cost countries, but the technical know-how and management capabilities are not that of the standard that we expect from China. Because we have built up quite a really good system now in China. You can expect high quality of production from China. And big corporates like the US manufacturers, they have their orders, OEMs in China, and they have the assurance of the qualities of their products to be sold in the US and in Europe.
Well, let's talk about competition within China itself, because most of the textile industry is based in Guangdong province still,
mm-hmm.
but your company, Huafeng, is based in Fujian province. How can you compete?
Fujian province is near the ocean. We have the added advantage of water supply, and the central government has a policy on controlling these sort of facilities. So Fujian is, at this moment, especially where our factories is located in Shaanxi, Fujian province, the central government has a policy on controlling polluted industries such as dyeing business within certain district, and Fujian is one of the districts that the central government is focusing on and restricting. No more new license will be granted.
Okay, but now quickly, Sonny, we have less than a minute left. Now, Huafeng just raised about 250 million Hong Kong dollars. What do you plan to do with that money?
Well, 70 million will go to repaying the existing syndication loan. 85 million will go to an acquisition of a new dyeing plant. And then the rest will go to probably we're going to build a fabric manufacturing plant near our existing plant. So the money will be well spent, and we expect good results from these expansions.
All right, Sonny. Thank you so much for joining us. Sonny Lee at Huafeng Textile Industry. Now checking crude futures for October delivery. They're falling for the first time in 3 days. We'll have more on crude with my next guest right after this break.